Hello everyone, welcome to my After Effects tutorial. Today we're going to create the text peel paper effect in After Effects. No plugins are required. Open After Effects. Go to the project panel. Create a new composition. Change comp name to main. Preset custom. Width 1920. Height 1080 pixels. Frame rate 29.97. Set duration time to 10 seconds. And click OK. We're going to work with this folder called Tutorial. And make sure to well organize your project panel. I will give you the project file download link in my description. First, we need to create a plain background. Right click to create a new solid. Make comp size and click OK. Now go to the effect and presets, type fill. Drag and drop on the solid layer. Set the color to something like dark blue. Now lock this. We do not want to disturb this. Now go to the tab menu. Select the T icon to create a new text. Now type peel. You can type any text you want. Make sure to align the text layer. I am using Poppin's extra bold font. You can download it anywhere on the website. Now select the text layer, right click to create a shape from the text. Listen carefully. For paper peel effect, we need to animate separate letters. As you see, we have four letters, so we need to duplicate it three times. Now we have four layers. The next step is to change the layer names as I am showing. Now again, select the P layer. Open the layer. Open contents. Delete the other letters. You have to do the same process as I am showing. As you see, we have now separate layers. Now select all layers. Press Ctrl or Command Shift Home button to bring center the anchor point. Or otherwise, you can hold Ctrl or Command and double click on the pan behind Tool to center the anchor point. Now select the original text layer. Unhide the selection. Now select all separated layers. Hide it. Again, select the bottom text layer. Go to the effect and presets, type fill, drag and drop on the text layer. Now change the fill color to something like pink. Again, select all four separated layers. Unhide the selection. Again, select the P text layer. Now go to the effect and presets, type CC page, turn. Drag and drop on the P layer. And adjust a few settings. Set controls to the top left corner. Now move the key point to something like this. As you can see, you can change any page turn position on controls. I am choosing the top left corner. Again, move the key point to something. Set fold radius to 150, light direction to 115, and change the back page to none, and source to effects and mask, change back opacity to 100. Now click on the stopwatch icon, fold position to create a keyframe. Now press U to open only keyframes. Press Shift down, page 3 times to move forward 1 second. Now change the key point position to something like this. As you see, the background color is not good. Let's fix this later. First, select all keyframes. Press F9 to easy ease. Open the graph editor and change the graph value to something like this. Now we have to give some paper floating animation. To do that, go to the effects control, on the fold position, hold Alt click to open the expression, type wiggle open bracket 4, commas 40, and close bracket. Press the spacebar button to preview. As you see, the background color is disturbing. Let's fix this. Go to the effects control. Change the paper color with the help of the color pick tool. I am going to choose the same pink color. Now again, go to the effect presets. Type drop shadows. Drag and drop on the P layer and adjust a few settings. Set opacity amount to 40. Change the direction to 300. Set distance to 20 and softness 80. You have to do the same process to the other 3 letter layers. Hit the spacebar button to reveal the entire project. At the end of this year, my target is to reach 100K. Please support me to reach 100K. I hope you all enjoyed my tutorial. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.